and this is the art, is the intelligent.
He wears the planetary body.
centers in his body. Each speak as each human center. A, B, C, D, E. Vibrates on one thing. Have its own coloring. Resemble, when seen from the higher plane, a vast lotus. Possess, according to its vibratory capacity, a definite number of centers. Be connected in geometrical formation with certain other centers of make a systemic triangle 0.32. Plane F. Characterized by different stages of activity according to the initiation towards which the other may be working. One center or heavenly man may be the subject of logoic attention and a specialized stimulation, and at another period a totally different scheme may be the object of vitalization. Four. Sometime the man has turned his attention to the Earth's scheme and to Saturn, whilst Uranus is receiving. 32 of him is this triangle of forces conveyed in letters on occult meditation, page 79-84, when speaking of man and his centers. 358-ATREATISE on cosmic fire. Simulation. Much is therefore accentuated, and increased evolutionary development is the consequence of this divine attention.
Thank you.
it otherwise, magnetism is felt by his brothers in a greater or less degree according to the work being undertaken at any one time. At present, the heavenly men, representing centers at different stages of stimulation, being not all equally developed and being not as yet psychically unified, yet the magnetic interplayer psychic flow from one scene to another is little utilized or comprehended. As time elapses on this interplay, the force will become more evident and the force will be consciously employed. When men, for instance, know the quality of the force flowing through their particular scene, the purpose and name of the center they stand within, the center or heavenly man with whom the logo with their scene is allied, which two schemes form, with their own, a triangle for the will force at a certain stage of evolutionary development. The secret of the cycle, or the periods of stimulation or inspiration, when will the body of the world begin to achieve this purpose? 360 ATREATINE on cosmic fire. Then will the world of our system begin to blend and merge and coordinate all of the vehicles. Then will the force flow through all the centers unimpeded, and then will the glory shine out, and each cell in every body will go it, planetary, and human, blaze forth with perfected glory, vibrating just like accuracy, and a major cosmic initiation mutation. The logos of our scheme. The heavenly man or planetary logos of the Earth scheme can be considered in various ways, and as is our custom, we will simply tabulate the statements and mention them. Considered at length by the individual student, should serve to make the fact of the essential personality of this great entity, the work that he is endeavoring to accomplish, and the relationship of the human hierarchy to him, a greater reality. We must bear in mind in studying this matter that it will not be possible to reveal for general publication details as to his specific identity, his number and his scope of conscious development. Such mysteries, as earlier pointed out, are reserved for those who are less conscious pilots. But some general idea may be conveyed before we take up specifically this chain and ground. We might be asked wherein all this information is assumed, and what purpose it serves in this hour of the world.
Each of the
minor ranges, and as we know, eventually synthesize the corresponding that range represented on our Earth by the Mahajo and Milky Way. We have seen our third major ray or aspect, and synthesized these before. These four ranges are symbolizing rain-making five rays of modern or mind. You can consider them as individualized heavenly men, called the mind-born sons of Brahma. Through the individualization of the Lord in that system, the individualization of the great cosmic entity we call Brahma was brought about. He individualized in the foregoes of the content of his body. They are represented on our earth by the five Kumaras who obey the law. Thank you. inside the solar sphere. Realization, we must add yet a further fact that the fourth creative hierarchy is the one whose evolution we are considering, and it will be apparent to the most superficial student that in these thoughts lies hidden the clue, not only to man but to the entire cyclic evolution in which he is taking part. The fourth creative hierarchy is essentially the hierarchy of manas. This is no my own words. A statement of meaningful significance. The statement has been made with entire accuracy that five hierarchies out of the 12 have passed out and that seven remain. Of these seven, our human hierarchy is the fourth, making it literally the ninth when counting the entire 12. In this connection, it would be well to link up the statements that have been made to the effect that the five Kumaras are heavenly men who definitely embody the manas of principle, for the five rays of the system is correspondence to the Mahatma and provides death. 34 is also the following correspondences, the sacred tetrad. incarnation in